Lieutenant Commander Buck O'Hare. You have been approved for the command of USS Plunger, SS-179, a porpoise-class submarine assigned to the Asiatic Fleet. Report for duty at Premantle, WA, Australia. No later than April 14th, 1942.
We've got it. Our intel guys have broken the Japanese communications code, and we finally have the chance to do something real about it. A Japanese amphibious assault is on its way towards Port Moresby. The fall of Port Moresby and the rest of New Guinea would provide the Japs with a platform ideally placed for an offensive towards New Caledonia, Fiji, and Samoa, which would cut our supply lines between Hawaii, Panama, and Australia. It would also strengthen the line of defense for their newly acquired oil source. Since we stopped them to the north on the mountain line, Japan's only choice is to approach through Coral Sea for the attack. Our intelligence predicts that invasion forces would be escorted by at least two fleet carriers. To counter their intentions, we have ordered the only two battle-ready carriers we have at the moment to take position off the New Hebrides. With help from land-based air power, we might match the Japanese attack and turn the tables on them. To support this operation, our submarines will patrol the area between New Britain and Bougainville. They will provide advanced scouting to the U.S. task force and may get to take a shot at a Japanese flat top.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Silent Hunter 4. Here we are with a new submarine. Same old skipper, Buck O'Hare, but we've been assigned to a new region. Yes, we are going to be in the Asiatic Fleet with USS Plunger. And the reason I've done that, the real reason is that we've had a complete reinstall and a new mod pack installed. Hopefully it's going to be a little bit more stable than we have in the past. I think we ended the USS Perch's last patrol about April 1942. I think it was about 7th of April. So as you can see, the start date for this new campaign is only a week later. So that's probably a transfer over to the Asiatic Fleet in Australia to take command of the new boat. So this is our new ship, and see what damage we can do with the USS Plunger. Of course, that does mean that because of the reinstall, and it's basically a new game, we do not have any of the tonnage that we have secured to that point, though the Congo class battleship and all the merchant ships that we sunk, plus a destroyer, they are linked to the USS Perch and not the USS Plunger. So Buck O'Hare starts once again from the bottom, but that's okay, we'll fight our way to the top. So without any more time wasting, let's find out our assignment. So April 14th, 1942, to Buck O'Hare, USS Plunger. Departs on the April 15th, 1942. Proceed to area D3 and engage in anti-shipping operations off the Gulf of Siam within the designated area in the South China Sea for 5 days. Be careful in your attacks, since hiding places are tough to come by here. We suspect the northwestern Gulf may have been mined. Oh joy. So yeah, that is where we are going to be hunting, near Saigon and Phuket, north of Singapore. It's an area we know well from our War on the Sea campaign. So we've got Borneo here and Sumatra. Okay. Hi everyone, welcome to the USS Plunger. Yes, another porpoise class submarine, one we are used to. Buck O'Hare has obviously proven himself on the Perch, and now Plunger is in the Asiatic fleet to try and do some damage on this side of the map, as it were. So yeah, it's quite exciting. We're just turning away from Australia. Australia's over there. Can you see it? Not really. But yeah, we're just heading out. And yeah, all things well, we should be good. Now, I didn't get a choice of loadout this time. So unfortunately, all we've got is Mark 14 torpedoes. That's all they had down here in Australia, no Mark 10s. So we're just going to have to try and do our best with what we've got, which is these Mark 14s. They've worked well for us in the past, but yeah, we'll just have to see if their reliability stays as it was. I doubt it. So yeah, as we set sail, I'll show you the course we are going to sail. Zoom out, here we are. Western Australia. Fremantle is our home base. So we're heading up here past the Australian coast, past Java and Sumatra, sneaking in through here, and then we'll be heading up past Singapore to our area where we need to patrol for 5 days. Previously, you'll be aware we were based at Pearl Harbor, so it's quite a transfer, and we were doing a lot of hunting in the East China Sea down here, weren't we? So yeah, different parts of the ocean, but we should be good. Should be good. There's plenty of action down here. But we've got a large sail in front of us, so we'll get on that, and hopefully, well, it should be plain sailing until we reach Java. So we'll just get our heads down for the moment and yeah, cruise across the ocean. Hi everyone, right, we've made some really good distance and we're heading well. Our patrol zone is up there, in that direction. However, we have detected contacts this way, so we've turned the boat to course, well, I think it was heading 77. And, oh, there they are. There's two, one there, one there. You can just about make out the vessels on the horizon. Dead ahead. Now then, they look like they're going, well, to our left. So we're going to keep an eye on them, and then we're going to see if we can set up an ambush. But we'll have to turn to port and just sort of head that way to get an angle so we can fire some torpedoes at them. The water is lovely and still, as you can see. So yeah, no big waves to cause the Mark 14s to go erratic or explode early, here's hoping. So yes, it's lovely weather conditions to get some torpedoes off. Potentially we could use the deck gun, but it's worth pointing out, here's the deck gun, it's worth pointing out, we don't have the ammo we once did. I think there's like 1400 shells in stock. Vanilla version of Sun Hunter 4. We've got, well, 140 high explosive, 120 armor piercing, and whatever we've got in star shells. So we're going to trundle forward. There they are, and see if we can. We'll obviously have to slip beneath the waves, because if they spot us, they'll start weaving. And it'd be difficult to try and hit them. If they've got a deck gun, then not, you know, it's not something we can engage on the surface. So it's best, as we're, there's a lot of unknowns at the moment, and there's two of them. So if they've both got deck guns, they could really punish us. And our patrol would be over before it's really begun. So yeah, we're going to close in a little bit, then. Set up an ambush and we'll drop below the waves and raise the periscope and see if we can set up an ambush and have a closer look at what these are. Hi everyone, right, welcome back. Right, we've got them plotted. We're trying to get into a position to intercept now. Just doing a quick speed check. You can see it's been going 3 minutes and coming out to 3:15. It's this lead ship that we are doing the check on. There. Lovely. So they are doing a grand total of 9.5 knots. So let's say 10 knots. Let's see if we can plot their rough course. Alright, that is their course there. More or less. Right, so there's our intercept point. How far are we from the intercept point? We are 2.26, fantastic, right. Right, having a look on the periscope. Are they similar ships? Yes, they're similar, aren't they? Same H-shaped front and aft deck, large funnel in the middle. It's just the front one's got some crazy camo painting style going on. Let's have a look then. What are they? Well, we're looking for one with a big middle funnel. It could... No, it's not that. Obviously got a big superstructure bit here as well. Possibly a Hansa freighter. That's the best we've got so far. Let's have a quick scoot through, see if there's anything more. Ah, no, that looks like the Kitty, doesn't it? I think it's a medium modern split freighter. Let's get that identified. Oh, let's track it. There we go. Right. So, we got it identified. We know it's doing 11 knots. 10 knots, wasn't it? 10 knots, beg your pardon. Well, 9.5 knots. Goes up to 10. Fine. Right, we're going to fire at the second one first. Calculations are the same. Almost up to the attack point, which is there. Tube 3. Fire. Tube 1. Fire. Right, quickly switch to this one. Open tubes 2 and 4. Tubes 4, fire. Tubes 2, fire. Okay, we've had two good strikes on this second ship, the first one we fired at. She's definitely slowed down. Unfortunately, the timing was a little bit out. The front ship was able to dodge and turn into the torpedoes, and they weren't actually in front of the bow, which is unfortunate. We've got nothing more to fire at them at the moment. So unfortunately, we're just going to have to sort of sit here and... watch her sail away. This one, however, seems to be almost dead in the water. Her pace has significantly slowed. They do have deck guns. Oh, fore and aft, actually. Same for this one. So I can't pop up and finish them off with a deck gun, otherwise I could receive a little bit of incoming fire my way. So, disappointing. That was almost a brilliant attack. But these modern split freighters. I took two torpedoes and it's still going. Only 2,700 tons, roughly. Definitely looks lower at the stern there, doesn't it? I think we've got her, but I do not believe we're going to get the torpedoes reloaded in time to have another shot at this one. Right, there she is. She's still kind of afloat. I might send Tube 1 to try and finish her off. Three torpedoes. She's one tough ship. I should just be patient. I think she's going down. Tube 1, fire. It's only going to be a 25 second wait. She is sinking, but taking a long time to do so. The other ship is long gone. But torpedoes should be sailing towards that target now. Three torpedoes should definitely be enough for this. Nice. Third hit. That should be a kill. There we go. Navigator, we hit it. It's taking water and going down. Sweet. Life rafts have been deployed. Our first kill with USS Plunger. Ooh, fire's breaking out the front. Is there going to be an explosion as she goes down? There we go. Okay, let's have a look then. So, April 26th, 1942, 3 minutes past 2 a.m. We've ship sunk a Hansa. Oh, it's a Hansa freighter. 7,900 tons. Okay, we got that slightly wrong, didn't we? Let's have a look. We thought it was this. It's a Hansa. Okay, so they're saying they reckon it's a Hansa freighter. It's got a fast Hansa merchant here. We did look at that, but we thought no, didn't we? Oh no, it's this one. Okay, that is what that's what it was. 7,800 tons, and we thought it was that one. Okay, never mind. Okay, good. 7,900 tons. That's very good. Right. Okay. So where are we? We're down here somewhere, aren't we? We're under about where this number 40 is. So you can see this is the survival to the end of hostilities major Japanese convoy route round here. Okay, nice. Sweet. Okay, good stuff. Hi everyone, right, we've just been buzzed by the looks of it. Battle stations, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Put your hard hats on. Good stuff. Alright, we've just gone to flank speed.
Yes, sir. Largest armor.
Yes, sir. Largest armor.
Aircraft spotted on the radar. Don't see at the moment. But we're just manning. Oh, there it is. Drop, missed us. Got an engine on fire. Get that reloaded. Thankfully that dodge at the last minute seems to have thrown their aim off, which is good. Where'd he go? He had a burning engine. I was looking elsewhere. Oh, there he is. Hopefully that's him done. Right, he seems to have gone into the cloud, away from our visibility. So there we go. Don't know if he's actually going to crash or if he's going to take that smoky engine back to base, but they know we're here. They've spotted us. Best thing we can do, well, yes, slow down from flank speed. Don't burn all that oil and fuel. Come off battle stations. I love this. Go back into casuals or into uniform.
From battle stations.
Right. We're going to continue on up to the patrol routes or the designated zone where we can go hunting. Don't see any more aircraft at the moment. Hi everyone. Right, a lot of time has passed. We're now 29th of April, so a couple of days passed. And all is well really. There's a lot of aircraft patrols we're picking up on the radar. Thankfully we get plenty of early warning on these now. And we've been able to dive away without any risk to the boat. Still circling around. We've still got a couple of more days to patrol this zone. We've done search patterns, we've dived down, listened on the hydrophone. There's no shipping here. There's absolutely no shipping here. If we have a look where we are, we've done sort of search pattern, sort of like a ladder pattern up there. We're now just sort of coming to the edge. The reason we're coming to the edge, because if you see, we're between Indochina, this kind of point, all the way to Malaya here. If we have a look at the map, so we are kind of here. In this kind of dead zone. So I'm hoping if we go to the edge of the map, so if we come sort of to here, we're kind of in line with Saigon, down to Singapore, and that's there. So this area here, we should be on this kind of dark pink major convoy relaying. That's what I'm hoping anyway, and that's what, if we can get there, then we've got a sporting chance of actually finding some ships. But yeah, I was doing a hunt up here, which is this dead zone here, which is a bit of a mistake. So I'm going to come down here, sort of start hunting in this kind of area, and hopefully we'll pick up a few more contacts, because there's absolutely nothing there. Right, we've just dived down. Enemy aircraft. Can't quite make out what that is. I know it's an aircraft, clearly. But it's a bit indistinct from here. Oh, it's a seaplane, isn't it? Okay, well. Yeah, she's going ahead of us. We've dived down to hide from her. But yeah, lots of maritime patrols going on. No doubt got depth charges and bombs on board, so yeah, we're gonna try and just avoid them. Well, welcome back everyone. Sea's got a bit choppier, as you can see. We're still moving. We've just detected on the sonar a enemy, well, potential merchant contact. Just turning the boat now, as you can see it's a bit choppy, so the deck gun will be out of action. Oh yes it will. But yes, good news. Here we go, we've picked up this sonar contact heading over there, so we're now turning the boat to head in that direction and figure out what the heck's going on. So this is that contact there at heading 006, it's a merchant. Just about hear it. So yeah, coming down here where the convoy lanes are, certainly paid off already. Right, here we are then. There they are. We've got, wow, that is an odd looking ship. It's a huge funnel. Two more ships here. Rolling and in the seas, trying to do, hopefully in a straight line. We know they're doing about 7 knots. Let's see if we can get these identified then. Right, bring up the targeting stuff. Let's risk a bit more height at this distance. Oh, it's not going to be working. So it could be that this time. Let's say that that is that. Oh god, the seas are a bit choppy, aren't they? There we go. Speed we know is 7 knots. Right, let's get torpedo tube 1 open and ready. Get 2 open as well. When she gets to 50, we will fire. That is what I've set it in at. Tube 1, fire. Right, lock onto this one. Torpedo in the water. Alright, I've heard the second boom. I will raise the periscope once again. Oh, she's still active. She's been hit by a torpedo. 2 good torpedo hits. She's firing her guns at us, so I'm not going to risk it. But yeah, 2 good hits. The first one looks destroyed. The second one's hit. Still firing. So we're going to give her a bit of time to allow the flooding to get on top of the rescue crews and hopefully abandon ship. Right, I don't think she's going to go down unless we give her a bit of a helping hand. So tube 3, fire. Torpedo away. It's a bad angle, but I'm hoping we can still get her. The other one. She looks, well, she's not gone yet. They seem to be remarkably sturdy and buoyant for this time. Yeah, she's almost underwater, but they're not going anywhere. It's been a bit of a while as well. Okay, that's definitely done her in. She's gone a strange green and brown and red colour. They've abandoned ship. Wow, look at that weird camouflage. Is that the other ship blowing up? Still going. Yes, with this troublesome one, she's gone. What is she? She was an auxiliary transport. 1,478 tons. Well, probably not worth 2 torpedoes. Now, this one, I don't think, has a deck gun. So, that one's definitely gone. Definitely gone. Crews have abandoned. Quick spin round to make sure the coast is clear. And we'll service the boat and try and finish this one off with the dead gun.
Yes, sir.
Right. She's definitely gone. She is in our sights. Right, let's turn the boat so we got a sporting chance of getting the gun to face her.
Yes, sir. Hard to starboard.
Yes, sir. Hard to starboard.
Slowly sinking that one. Well, the barrier's actually coming up. Got a bit of air trapped in it, no doubt. Okay. Alright, we're loading high explosives as the gun swings around. Right, should we have a pop at 1,000 yards? Sure, okay. Let's go 2,000 yards. When ready. Good hit. Oh, is she actually going down? She could well be. No reports that she's sunk yet. So we'll fire a few more high explosive shells. I guess right on the waterline, that'd be nice. That'd be get some flooding going. Yeah, get these going, see if we can finish her off, and that will be not a bad start to this patrol. Yes, we've still got some. Thought the ship lurched. Is the ship lurching or is it just my eyes? I don't know. But yeah, we've still got some patrolling to do in this region. It's now, what was it? 2nd of May. I think I said March earlier, of course I meant May. Yeah. Maybe another day and we should be cleared to leave. Oh, there you go, something hot. Oh, it's the mast just fell off. There we go. I was going to say get some fires going, but she's got a pretty healthy fire going on the front. Nice and toasty indeed. We got some holes at the rear. She's sailing away from us. We'll increase the range of touch. Yeah, just to make sure the crew's become overwhelmed with the fires and the flooding. Oh, there we go. That looks healthy. There's a fire going on the back now. Let's give it a moment. Okay, we get some good hits into the stern of this ship now. Fire's breaking out. Little combustions and things blowing up. Oh, there we go. Oh. Well, that doesn't look healthy. I'll hold off firing. Nothing's showing up on our captain's log at the moment. Surely that's send another bit of encouragement. There we go, she's gone. A medium modern split freight for 2,775 tons. Happy days. Good stuff. Let's stow the deck gun. So as they stow the deck gun, we can come off battle stations.
Secure from battle stations.
Good stuff. And there she goes. Kill number 3. Happy days, happy days, happy days. So we start this patrol with, what's that, 8,000, 10, 11, almost 12,000, well, around about 12,000 tons. Already, and we haven't even finished this initial patrol. We've completed that now that we've been hunting these down, so we are free to go on our own mission. Our patrol is complete, which is delightful, which means the world is our oyster. We can have a look. We're getting tube 2 loaded now, so we've got 3 forward firing tubes with torpedoes. We've got 2 in the rear and 2 reserves. So yes, we can still have a little bit of fun. For sure, for sure. But for that now, I think we're going to leave it there. It's been a... Well, we will go offer some assistance to these crew in the life rafts, I suppose. Yeah, we have made a good start to the career of USS Plunger, with Buck O'Hare once again in charge. He's proving to be a lucky commander for these boat crews. 12,000 tons already sunk on our first patrol with Plunger. We are now free to roam the seas, and we'll go hunting down those convoy lanes as best we can. But we'll pick this up again next time. Thank you ever so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying this, and I hope we'll have a long and successful career in USS Plunger and with the fall of the Rising Sun mod as well. So thanks ever so much. Take care. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.